main message for tonight is the following. The Design Leadership Network remains committed to building strength and value within and on behalf of the design community. We're going to spend the next 2 days together listening, learning, sharing, and connecting.
I enjoy the obsession with detail, but it's, I can't separate it from the big picture, because in a way you need both. You need the big vision.
The customer wants to move between digital and the offline world, whether you want her to or not. That is the truth, because your customer is living in an exceptionally busy world.
The age of man-made things is essentially ending. And in fact, when you talk to many young people, you notice they have far fewer things. What they do want is experience. They do want more of an internal life. They do want more connectivity, more social, more feeling of being part of the world. That's the world you're designing for, ladies and gentlemen.
The philosophy that we had at Partners in Spades, philosophy is, the bigger you get, the smaller you should act. It's all about creating a personality.
Your currency is your imagination. And if you're outgunned and if you're outfinanced, what they need to be afraid of and terrified of is your imagination.
I think that my role as a designer is to create things that the woman, first of all, will feel that I understood who she is, and that I love her.
Oh, we all feel that way.
Artists don't have a corner on creativity. It doesn't really matter what you do, it's how you do it. I think that's true of any profession. I mean, I know artists who are not very creative, and I know lawyers who are very creative.
One of my favorite a little haikus by Lao Tzu, which is, we mold clay into a pot, but it is the emptiness inside that makes the vessel useful. And it's that kind of emptiness, that space, that pause, that we need to reintegrate into our lives, both for the sake of aesthetics and for the sake of our health.
In my day, you were thrown in to work under a designer. And my great good fortune was to go to John Fowler. And of course, my first job was to make tea. Well, I went into Mr. Fowler and I said, "Mr. Fowler, here is your tea." And he said, "Dear child, please never make tea again." So, inspiration number one, do menial jobs really badly and you will be promoted.
The sense of intuition plays such an important role. Where we're blessed with such amazing editors in this building is the role of instinct to understand what consumers really want.
I want to give my reader what they didn't know they wanted.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You have to be able to surprise. If you keep churning out the same thing every month, there's a point where you just think, oh, did I get that one already? Or you're bored by it.
And I always think the best sign of any good design is that the place has to have atmosphere with no one in it. And if you start with that basis, then when it does fill up with people, then it has a fantastic atmosphere.
Every time you come to me with an idea, I'm thinking about, you know, the teenage years and the 20s and the 30s. And you're just thinking about how much fun it'll be to have that one night together.